The golden ratio is a brilliant and remarkable way by which a number of architectural buildings, sculptures, designs, images, etc. can be created. The golden ratio is fundamentally an irrational number, which is obviously infinite. Since the golden ratio is infinite, it has no ends, and so the various philosophers and mathematicians round off this infinite number to three digits, and in this way, the golden ratio, which is 1.618, was procured. The golden ratio has a number of names, which is mentioned in the chapters, which also justify that why it has a number of names. Some of the names are kept by a number of different sculpture artists, architects, and mathematicians. The golden ratio is so much related to the nature of not only the planet Earth, but of the universe too. Everything in this world, in the universe, has some relations and relevance with the golden ratio. This is another reason why it became so popular thousands of years back, and still it is enormously popular. To understand the golden ratio, it is critically not worthy to understand the proper definition of the golden ratio, along with the numerous applications and theories by different philosophers, mathematicians and artists, such as Leonardo da Vinci, etc. In the chapters, the relationship of between the Fibonacci series or sequence is also described and demonstrated. It is also mentioned and described that how the golden ratio is related with the structures and the architectures. The golden ratio is applied on various shapes such as circles, rectangles, squares, triangles, etc. The usage of the golden ratio is absolutely essential in the architecture of buildings. There are a number of architectures which were built in the past where the golden ratio was applied and followed. In the chapters, there is a description about such architectures and sculptures. Apart from this, it is very essential to understand and possess the knowledge about the history of the golden ratio. Many eminent philosophers, painters, mathematicians and artisans were involved in the history of the golden ratio. With the help of these great people in the past, the introduction of the golden ratio to the world became possible. The golden ratio was used in some of the great paintings also which were recognized worldwide. The history of the golden ratio is also carried forward from different countries such as Greece, Egypt, Italy and America, etc. The different philosophers and mathematicians from these different countries have bestowed their views on the golden ratio and have demonstrated the use and the effects of the golden ratio. This has helped and encouraged the ordinary people to be aware of the fact that the golden is in fact very important and worthy for the construction purposes and in various art forms. The use of the golden ratio also depends on the purpose, and the purpose can be the construction of a building or any painting. The golden ratio is used to convey a message to the world in the form of art and images, etc. There are a number of applications which are used in the golden ratio in order to highlight a magnificent and understandable example to the common people. The golden ratio is very important, and it can be seen in nature itself, or it can be stated that nature has bestowed the gift of golden ratio. The golden ratio is present everywhere in different forms. As discussed earlier, it has a number of names, and these names are associated with a number of jobs which takes place when required in distinct fields. The applications of the golden ratio consist of many natural things, such as leaves or a human finger, etc., which proves the existence of the golden ratio in nature, and it also helps in the proper application of the golden ratio. The use and the application of the golden ratio can also be seen in a number of places and fields. The golden ratio is used in the field of mathematics as well as in the field of physics. These are just the educational fields where the usage of the golden ratio is utilized in a proper manner. Apart from these fields, there are also a number of domains such as designing, photography, where the golden ratio can be applied and used in a very convenient way. Golden ratio is highly used in the designing purposes, and it also has a lot of shapes which can be used for the designing. It helps in creating various designs for a website or a home. It does not matter which technology is being used, the beauty of the golden ratio is that it is not partial or biased. It can be used in every area, and when it comes to the designing part, it is very helpful. The golden ratio is also used in the creation of logos or icons, which are very important for the identification of a company or business. As the golden ratio has a number of shapes in its bucket, it becomes easy to create great designs and architectures from it. The golden ratio is also used in the construction of the furniture. This came as a surprise for a lot of people, but there is hardly some difference between the construction of furniture and building in terms of the dimensions. In the construction of a building, there is a need of proper proportion or dimension, whereas in the construction of furniture, there is also a need of the proper dimensions, which can help the furniture to take proper shape in the desired size and ratio. It is also discussed that whether the golden ratio, which has a history of more than 4,000 years, has any chance of existence in today's world. This is a great but confusing question in front of the human race, but sincerely, no one can deny the existence of the golden ratio, as it is present everywhere, and most interestingly, it is an important aspect and part of nature, which is a fact which cannot be taken away.